Welcome to today's video. Today's video, we're going to be talking B or D mode. Now, if you have an electric car and has B and D mode, like the Renault Zoe ZE50 I've got here, and you don't know which is the most efficient or which one you should be using, should it be B, should it be D, is it an interchange between the two, then we're going to be answering all those questions and what's the most efficient way of driving one of these. But it's not the most obvious answer that you'd think. I'd like to say a special thank you to the Renault EV Club. You can visit their webpage or their Facebook page if you have any Renault electric questions or you're thinking of buying a Renault Zoe or Renault electric Megane. Now let's go into some basics. If you put the car into D mode, that's drive, and you've put your foot on the brake and you release the brake after putting it into D mode, you will roll forward on a Renault Zoe. Like most automatic cars, petrol cars, diesel cars do exactly the same in automatic. When you let go of the pedal, they start to roll forward. Now, what happens if you're doing 30 miles an hour and you let go of the accelerator and don't press the brake? In the Renault Zoe ZE50, the 22 and the ZE40, you'll get some regenerative braking. Not harsh, but a little bit of regenerative braking, which is energy that is being saved and put back into the battery rather than going into the brake discs, you know, to slow down the car. B mode came around due to other manufacturers at the time offering a much more aggressive regen style, which meant effectively you could drive on one pedal because the regen was so strong in these B modes and more regenerative braking styles that you didn't really need to use the brake. You could just drive purely on the accelerator. Now, Renault decided to somewhat copy this idea by going for a much more aggressive B mode, more regenerative braking mode in that system, meaning that more of that power is put back into regenerative braking and you can drive closer to more of a one pedal driving style. However, unlike some other manufacturers, Renault decided that the B mode would still roll forward at about 5 miles an hour compared to other manufacturers, but you do get a much more aggressive regen style from D to B and have the option of both. Now the question is, what mode should you be driving in? Some people believe that D mode is better, other people believe that B mode is better. Some people like to mix things up and use D mode on motorways where they're less likely to be stopping and slowing down constantly, and use B mode in more town and rural areas where stopping and starting is a lot more common. And some people believe that B mode is more efficient. Well, it's not, so let's explain why that is. But before I do, if you already own a Renault Zoe, a 22 kilowatt, a 40 kilowatt, or a 50, and you have a Renault extended warranty that you're extending direct through Renault, then stop. Because you can extend that warranty using the Renault EV Club for less money. Their club is completely free. There's no membership fees. You can use their club website at renaultevclub.co.uk or their Facebook page, links down below or on their website, and you can get an extended warranty through them at a discounted price that's less than the Renault website direct. And it's exactly the same warranty, exactly the same underwriter, exactly the same company. It's just through Smith's Motor Group instead of directly through Renault. So if you're already going to extend that warranty anyway and you want to save yourself a bit of money, go and check out the club. They are kind enough to sponsor this video and get some information out there to Renault Zoe owners like this and the other video I made the other week. So go and check their club out. I'll be on their forum page all the time answering questions when I can. So why isn't it more efficient? Well, using B mode uses more regen, and the more regen you're using, the more losses you're incurring. Regen is better than braking, but it's still not better than coasting. So if you can use as little regen as possible with as little brake as possible, you're going to get much more efficiency out of your car. And with BMO being much more aggressive on the regen, you may be tempted to use more regen than you would normally in D mode. If you want to get the most efficiency and eke those extra miles per kilowatt on your Zoe, then my personal advice would be use D, try and coast as slowly as you can with the accelerator pedal towards those lights, and then using as little regen as possible, come to a slower stop as you're getting to those lights. And if you really, really can time it, and you know when the lights are roughly going to go green because it's a regular road you drive, try and coast to those lights so slowly that you know you're going to get to the front of them without stopping at all, and as they hit green, set off as gently as possible. Efficiency is all about being gentle. The least amount of forcing stopping distance you can get, so the least amount of regen and braking you can do, the more regen you're going to get. The less regen you're going to get, the more efficiency you're going to get. And the slower you set off from lights, the more efficiency you're going to get. And B and D mode for me are two things that are very controversial. Some drivers are going to get more efficiency out of B mode, some are going to get out of D mode. It really depends on your driving style. But bear in mind, if you drive on D mode and use a little bit of that brake, you'll still increase your regen just as if you're in B mode, but have more control over how much regen you're applying yourself by applying that brake pedal yourself and increasing that regen. So hitting the brake on the Renault Zoe will not actually hit the brakes for quite some time if you're going quite some speed. You'll actually just be increasing regen. So as soon as you learn that point and you can feel the difference of grabbing the brake discs and just using regen, and you can use the blue bar on the dash to determine which point you're at when you're doing this, let me know down in the comments. Do the same road, same rough temperatures on a day, and do it on B and D mode using the two methods I said, and let me know what's more efficient. Either let me know down below in the comments or on the Renault EV Club webpage or their Facebook page. Now, one thing you can do, what most people don't realize, is you can actually use a combination of the two. And this is actually what I tend to use the most when driving. So I tend to be driving in D mode as normal. And if I can eke out those extra miles by cruising to the lights very, very slowly, or as little regen and little acceleration as possible, then I'll do that. But if the lights suddenly change to red, or the guy in front suddenly slows down a bit more rapidly than I thought, then as I'm driving, I will hit the gear selector down and select B mode. In other words, I'll change it on the fly depending on the road conditions. Now, this can be a little bit of a pain, and some people might not want to keep doing this, but it can be very useful to eke out some extra mileage, especially if you're not too sure on how heavy your right foot is to adjust that regen. You can slip it into B mode at any point. Now, many people didn't know that you can just change that B and D mode on the fly at any point by pulling it down while you're driving. That means that if you're coming on a motorway, you can switch it back to D, and if the motorway traffic starts to slow down because there's congestion, you can just pull it down again and go into B mode and get some of that extra regen if that's the way you want to do it. That's the way I do it. Let me know which way you do it down below in the comments. Thank you very much to the Renault EV Club for sponsoring today's video, and I'll see you again next week. Goodbye.